Hare Krishna. So one time, Shiva Kadamba Kanana Maharaj was here in Mayapur, and he was a little bit sick. We had to go on a parikrama to Godrum Dvip, to the house of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Surabhi Kunch. So Maharaj said, okay, I'll do kirtan, but I'll really not overdo it. So the parikrama maybe went for 3 or 4 hours, and Maharaj was leading at least 2, 2.5 hours. And then all the devotees, they became a little tired. We were already coming in Mayapur, and just we were entering the main gate of the campus, and the kirtan party just came in front of us and said, Maharaj, you promised that you are going to lead some kirtan. So then Maharaj said, okay, just little bit. And then he went for 3 hours. And then when after that we were going to his room, he was really feeling tired, and he said, okay, I overdid it again.
He has some private things also. It was like Goloka to have him and Kiruvach in the house. And I always try to hide myself because I'm a little bit shy. And then he always asked, where's Jayanti? Where's Jayanti? I cannot find her. Yeah. It was one of my greatest moments to have him home. Yeah.
Maharaj is truly a wish-fulfilling tree. He fulfills all the wishes. For example, my husband always told me before I got initiated, I took a long time to get initiated, and before he always told me, When you will be initiated, your name will be Sudevi. And I didn't like it. Sudevi, it was too simple. A lot of Sudevis around. But then, someday I got initiated and Maharaj said, from now on, your name will be Sudevi. And I was, wow. Okay. So he fulfilled the wish of my husband that my name will be Sudevi. And he didn't know about it. And from his lips, I liked it. I totally liked it. I could.
I really did already. I don't have another story. No, really. Stop it.
Of brand. And I heard from other god sisters, or like he doesn't like to be like applause after his kirtan. He just wants to serve and be our friend and help us on our way back home to God, back home to Krishna.
Whilst we were in Mayapur, we found out that Maharaj wasn't doing so well. So then Malini and Kirti got together and they thought it would be a good idea for us to have a kirtan and to share prasadam. Wasn't too bad either. So this caused us to put our heads together to come up. with other occasions where we could meet and have kirtans. Oh yeah, and prasad. Of course, without waiting until Maharaj gets sick again.
One time Maharaj was buying books from ILS, from Radhadesh, and he bought quite some books. So there was a brahmachari there. He decided, okay, let me just render some service to Maharaj. So he offered Maharaj, let me help you with the books. And then Maharaj said, just give me a break, like I can do it on my own. And he turned to Vishnumurti, who is the owner of ILS, and said, a little more, they will want to come in the toilet with me. I cannot understand. I can do everything alone. So Maharaj has this nature to be as much as independent from everybody else and depend on Krishna.
Having amazing association with almost four god sisters, and I just wasn't expecting this, and yeah, we happen to have one big thing in common, and it's our beloved Guru Maharaj. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Swami. I hope she's gonna allow me to say what I've been trying to say. What I wanted to say is I don't think this is gonna sound funny, but that's how it went last time when Maharaj went to Australia, and it just happened to be like 1 week before I was coming to India, and I really wanted to see him because he couldn't come at the beginning of the year, and I wanted to ask for his blessing. So I decided I wanted to go and see him in this first city where he is arrived, and so I drove a few hours from Melbourne, and I had brought something for him from Colombia, which was, I know he can't eat nuts, but I was hoping that he could have peanuts. And so there was this nice peanuts covered in organic jaggery or something. And so when I arrived in Canberra, and then when I saw him later on, I just said, oh, I have a little thing for you. And so I gave it to him, and he said, like, I can't have peanuts. I said, they're organic. And then he said, even if they're organic, I can't have them. And then, okay, Maharaj, we give it to somebody else then. So anyway, I was so happy I got to see him, and I asked him for his blessings before coming to the dump and before leaving Australia. So luckily, then during Kartik, he was in Mayapur, and I was just hoping that I would have the chance to have like a proper darshan with him. So in some point it became like, oh, maybe it's not even gonna happen here because it's more busier than in Australia. It was very busy with the schedules and program, and it's more disciples there, and I was like, no, it's not gonna happen here either. But one of our god sisters, she's very keen, and she knows pretty closely like what's going on with Maharaj programs and every movement he does. And thanks to her mercy, I happened to know that Maharaj was seeing some devotees in the Bhajan Kutir, and so I went there with her, and then he saw me, and it wasn't planned obviously, but then when he saw me, he just called me, and I was, oh my god, it's happening. And as soon as I just stepped into the Bhajan Kutir, he happened to have some sweets from Colombia that I don't know who gave it to her, but to him, sorry. And it's this coconut and jaggery candy as well. And he just threw it to me, like, he said, from Colombia, organic. And then it was okay, I really like it, and I will have it, thank you very much.
Thank you. No, it's not.